Hey everybody, Ace here. Becoming a millionaire is going to be extremely difficult if you have terrible spending habits. It doesn't matter how much money you make. You could be making $100,000 a year, but if you're spending $100,000 a year or more, you will never become rich. Many rich people, like Floyd Mayweather, Michael Vick, or even other famous athletes, have lost all of their money because of their terrible spending habits. So I'm gonna walk you through 6 ways you can spend less money. Let's get into it. 1, whenever you go shopping, write down every single thing you need and then only buy what is on that list. Do not get distracted by the sales, especially if there's sales on Oreos, because I know how delicious and addicting they are and they pair perfectly with milk. But if it's not on your list, do not buy it. Do not buy anything that is not on that list. Stores are designed specifically to make you spend as much money as possible, but your goal needs to be to save as much money as possible. And that's where writing that list comes in handy. If you're shopping around and a store has a sale price and it says, save $50 on this $100 item, you're not actually saving $50. You're actually spending $50 if you buy that item, unless it was on your list specifically, which I would dare to bet that it wouldn't be. 2, track all of your expenses, or what I like to do, keep a budget. I recently went over my budget in one of my previous videos, which I'll link up above. Tracking all of your expenses will guarantee you that you're not spending more money than you make, and it'll help you save money in the long term. If you don't have any idea where your money's going, how do you expect to spend less and save more? 3, don't spend money on drinking or smoking. And I know this is gonna be a very controversial point, especially coming from someone living in Wisconsin, which is probably the drinking capital of the United States. But listen to me, the average person spends $1 for every $100 they make on alcohol. That is a lot of money. Alcohol and smoking, whether that be cigarettes or the devil's lettuce, are not necessities to life. Yes, I understand, they can be fun to do socially, but they're not necessities. So if you could cut back or just eliminate them completely, you'll be saving a lot of money. 4, shop generic. The main difference between brand names and generic names is gonna be the price. Sometimes the generic label is made in the exact same factory as the brand name label, and the only difference is the label that they put on the product and the price that you're gonna pay. Buying generic is gonna save you a lot of money over time, and you don't have to sacrifice quality for buying a generic brand. 5, pay with cash, especially if you're terrible at controlling your money. That means do not pay with a debit card or a credit card. When you pay with cash, you can actually feel and see the money leaving your pocket, making it easier to track. When you're out of cash, you're no longer allowed to spend. But if you're using a debit card or a credit card, it's very easy to overspend because you can't see or feel that money leaving your pocket. You end up having to check your bank account or your credit card statement later to see how much money you've actually spent, making it easier to overspend. Studies have shown if you pay with cash, your average purchase is gonna be less than if you're paying with debit or credit. And 6, pay your bills on time. This could be from your rent and utilities to your credit card. Not paying your bills on time will either accrue interest or add a late fee, meaning more money out of your pocket. That is a total waste of money. You're literally throwing your money down the drain, which is completely avoidable in that case. So do yourself a favor and pay everything on time, if not early. Yes, you can pay your bills early. These are just a few ways that you can spend less money. And with spending less money today means you'll have more money in your pocket tomorrow. And one day at a time, you'll be going from where you're at to becoming a millionaire. If you liked this video or learned anything, please just tap that thumbs up button for me and subscribe for more content. And until then, I hope to see you in the next video.